We all know the standard tanks that have become a meme today, but sometimes you come across a superior meme tank, a tank that already should have been a powerful meme, so forget your Tarks 2 and your petty Bob sample tanks. We have a new meme tank. The Praying Mantis was a private developed experimental machine gun carrier that started development in 1937, and the construction of a prototype began in 1943. The idea of the vehicle was that it could shoot over high walls and other high obstacles, but it could also have a really low profile, making the vehicle really hard to spot. The first prototype was mainly built to test the maneuverability and the position for the driver. In 1943, the second and last prototype would use the engine and running gear of the Universal Carrier. And as unusual as this vehicle is, so was the basic construction. It had the engine at the back and a shoebox-shaped fighting compartment that would raise up by an hydraulic system. And on top of the fighting compartment would be a pivoting turret with two Bren machine guns and a small grappling gun. But I cannot for the life of me figure out what the grappling gun was for. The crew would be lying down on top of the control in this boxy compartment, facing the machine gun turret. From there they could look forward, and there were a few ports on the back of the compartment, but it was almost impossible for the crew to turn their heads. This could be a leftover from the initial design because the box had the ability to move left and right as well, but the concept was dropped, probably because of production. As you would think, this thing was incredibly uncomfortable, and the vehicle would hobble and bobble around, and would sometimes even make the crew sick. And because the crew were lying on the controls of the vehicle, it was really hard to control. For the surviving examples, my first thought was there were only two left. One in the Bovington Tank Museum and one in the National Military Museum in Soest, the Netherlands. But many sources say there's only one example left. I filmed the one in Soest, and comparing the two together, they look sort of different, with a completely different paint job and hydraulic hoses visible on the outside of the Mantis, which the Bovington one doesn't have. I tried to contact Soest on this matter, but I did not get any emails back. I tried to look in their online archives, where I had seen some information on this Mantis before, but could not find anything anymore. So there are probably two left. Or the Soest Museum had their Praying Mantis on loan for a really short time and kept it in storage for many years before that, seeing that it was in their archives well before the museum even opened its doors in 2014. Nevertheless, I hope you guys enjoyed the last few minutes of this walk around. And if you have any idea on how many mantises are really left, let me know in the comments below.